This video is about the Rational Root Theorem. Our goals for this video are to state and prove the Rational Root Theorem, sometimes known as the Rational Zeros Theorem, and to work a few examples and concept checks. We will assume familiarity with the following useful facts. Number one, given integers r, s, and k, if r divides ks, and the GCD of R and S is 1, then R must divide K. This follows easily from Bayes' lemma. It would be a good exercise for you to prove it for yourself as a review. And two, what's usually known as the factor theorem, we will use in our examples. If C is a root of a polynomial f of x, then x minus C is a factor of f of x. In this video, we will use z to denote the set of all integers and q to denote the set of all rational numbers. Why do we need the rational root theorem anyway? As a motivating example, consider the polynomial g of x equals 2x to the 4 plus 14x cubed plus 25x squared plus 9x minus 15. Does g of x have rational roots? G of x is hard to factor. But the rational root theorem will show how the leading coefficient, in this case 2, and the constant term, in this case negative 15, of a polynomial with integer coefficients can be used to narrow down the number of possible rational roots or zeros the polynomial has. So here's the rational root theorem. It says, let f of x be a polynomial with integer coefficients. If r over s is a rational root of f of x, where r and s are integers and r over s is in lowest terms, then r must divide the constant term and s must divide the leading coefficient. In other words, by looking at the divisors of the constant term and the leading coefficient, we can narrow down the number of possible rational roots a polynomial has, so that we only have to check a hopefully short list. We will come back to the proof in a minute, but first, let's look at an example. Find all rational roots of f of x equals 2x cubed minus 5x squared plus 3x plus 3. According to the rational root theorem, we can look at the divisors of the constant term, which are plus or minus 1 and plus or minus 3, and the divisors of the leading coefficient, which are plus or minus 1 and plus or minus 2, and look at all combinations of fractions where the divisors of the constant term are in the numerator and the divisors of the leading coefficient are in the denominator. So here's our list. The possible rational roots are plus or minus 1, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 1/2, and plus or minus 3/2. The easiest one to check is 1, and we can check that f of 1 is not 0. Next easiest is probably negative 1. F of negative 1 is also not 0. Let's check the rest of the integers. F of 3, that's not 0. F of negative 3, also not 0. So now we come to plus or minus 1/2. F of 1/2 is not 0. But f of negative 1/2 is 0. So we have a rational root, negative 1/2. By the factor theorem, since negative 1/2 is a root, x plus 1/2 is a factor, and any rational multiple of x plus 1/2 is also a factor. So, in particular, 2x plus 1 is a factor. We can perform polynomial division to see that f of x factors as 2x plus 1 times x squared minus 3x plus 3. We can check that x squared minus 3x plus 3 is irreducible over the rationals. So f of x has no more rational roots. So here's the proof of the rational root theorem. Let f of x be a polynomial with integer coefficients. F of x equals a n x to the n plus a n minus 1 x to the n minus 1 plus and so on plus a1 x plus a0. And suppose r over s is a rational root of f of x, where r and s are integers and r over s is in lowest terms. Then, if we evaluate f of x at r over s, we should get 0 since r over s is a root. If we multiply this equation through by s to the n, we will clear all the denominators, and we'll end up with this expression, a n r to the n plus a n minus 1 r to the n minus 1 s plus and so on plus a1 r s to the n minus 1 plus a0 s to the n. And that's still equal to 0. We will finish our proof by rewriting this equation in two different ways. First, rewrite it by subtracting a0 s to the n from both sides. Then we end up with negative a0 s to the n equaling something with a factor of r. When we factor out r, we can see now that r divides a0 s to the n. But the GCD of r and s is 1, and thus, by our useful fact number 1, r divides a0, which is half of what we wanted to prove. Then we will rewrite this equation in a different way by subtracting a n r to the n from both sides to get negative a n r to the n equaling an expression with a factor of s. Therefore, s divides a n r to the n. But again, the GCD of r and s is 1, so by our useful fact, s divides a n. And that completes the proof. As another example, consider g of x equals 2x to the 4 plus 14x cubed plus 25x squared plus 9x minus 15. This is the motivating example that we mentioned at the beginning of this video. The possible rational roots using the rational root theorem are plus or minus 1, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 5, plus or minus 15, plus or minus 1 half, plus or minus 3 halves, plus or minus 5 halves, and plus or minus 15 halves. That's a lot of possible roots to check. And in fact, you could go through the entire list and you would find that g of x has no rational roots. So the rational root theorem does have its limitations. Another caution, although g of x has no rational roots, in fact, g of x can still be factored over the rationals, since g of x can be written as 2x squared plus 8x minus 5 times x squared plus 3x plus 3. This is not easy to determine, but you can check that it is true. So not having rational roots does not imply that the polynomial is irreducible over Q. Here we come to a concept check. Pause and explore. I urge you to pause the video and complete the problem for yourself before going on. Given f of x equals 10x cubed minus x squared minus 11x minus 6, identify all possible rational roots of f of x according to the rational root theorem. Pause the video and come back when you're ready. Okay, so possible rational roots are plus or minus r over s, where r equals 1, 2, 3, or 6, and s equals 1, 2, 5, or 10. Since 1, 2, 3, and 6 are the positive divisors of the constant term, and 1, 2, 5, and 10 are the positive divisors of the leading coefficient. So let's list them all and then reduce. We have plus or minus 1 over 1, which is 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 6, plus or minus a half, plus or minus 2 halves, which is 1, so we already have that one listed, plus or minus 3 halves, plus or minus 6 halves, which is 3, and we already have that one listed, plus or minus 1 fifth, plus or minus 2 fifths, plus or minus 3 fifths, plus or minus 6 fifths, and plus or minus 1 tenth, plus or minus 2 tenths, that's 1 fifth, we already have that, plus or minus 3 tenths, and plus or minus 6 tenths, which is 3 fifths, and we already have that. So our final list of possible rational roots is as shown, plus or minus 1, 2, 3, 6, 1 half, 3 halves, 1 fifth, 2 fifths, 3 fifths, 6 fifths, 1 tenth, and 3 tenths. A few more remarks on this polynomial. We can check that negative 1 is a root of this polynomial, so by the factor theorem, x plus 1 is a factor of f of x. We can use polynomial division to factor f of x as x plus 1 times 10x squared minus 11x minus 6. At this point, we can keep trying possible rational roots, or we can simply factor 10x squared minus 11x minus 6, since it's a quadratic. We can use the quadratic formula to get x equals 3 halves or x equals negative 2 fifths. Sure enough, these are rational numbers that were on our list from before. Thus, again by the factor theorem, x minus 3 halves and x plus 2 fifths are factors of f of x. In fact, noting that our leading coefficient is 10, we can write f of x as 10 times x plus 1 times x minus 3 halves times x plus 2 fifths. Or if you prefer, you can multiply the 10 through to get f of x as x plus 1 times 2x minus 3 times 5x plus 2. In summary, the rational root theorem says that any rational root r over s in lowest terms of a polynomial with integer coefficients must have r as a divisor of the constant term and s as a divisor of the leading coefficient. We saw that the rational root theorem has its limitations. For one thing, the list of roots to check can still be long and tedious, and also that not having rational roots does not imply irreducibility over Q. As a question for further thought, if a polynomial with rational coefficients is of degree 2 or 3, then having no rational roots does imply irreducibility over Q. Why? I hope you found this video helpful.